Well, we wanted to see how deep the animals were sinking in the snow. So in Denali, we were focusing on moose and caribou, as climate change is making things warmer. That's going to affect how deep the snow is and how hard it is. Certain species like wolves and lynx, their feet kind of act like snowshoes and they can stay on top of the snow more easily. But their prey, like caribou and moose, are heavier and they have smaller hooves, so they tend to sink deeper, and that's going to give the predator an advantage.
Yeah, so Laura said, I need a snow expert. And Laura's asking really hard questions about snow.
Like, what specific snow densities would favor predators versus prey?
If to be a snow scientist, you have to like digging. We're like the people who never got over snow forts, you know.
We were sampling animal snow tracks and then digging snow pits to measure snow characteristics at those animal tracks. Those are wolf tracks. There's some caribou. And you can see the snow is much shallower there. So that's why they were hanging out there.
You take a cake slice of snow and then you weigh it. And that gives you the density per unit volume. This study lets you know, okay, at this density of snow, the animal sinks this far.
A wolf might stay on top of the snow at a density of maybe about around 300. What's the unit again?
Kilograms per meter cube.
Yeah. And a moose will keep sinking in until you're more like 450 kilograms per cubic meter.
Which is really high.
Deep, fluffy snow favors predators. Shallower, harder snow tends to be easier for prey to escape and move around. Snow conditions are changing with climate change, and so we think that's going to be one of the main ways that climate change affects wildlife in northern ecosystems is through changing snow, which is kind of an understudied topic.